What's up everyone, and thanks for joining me again this week. As you can tell, the scenery is a little different this week. I decided to rebuild my studio, build some actual walls, and I didn't finish in time for this video, so I'm kind of at the halfway point. I still need to paint. Hopefully by next week things will be done, but this is kind of a happy accident because this week's video is actually very relatable to my studio build project. See, to determine how much lumber I would need to frame the walls, I decided to write a SQL query to help me with the math calculations. So I'm trying to build one of my walls to be 6 feet long. I take 6 feet and multiply it by 12 inches and divide by 16 because I want a stud or wooden beam placed every 16 inches along my wall. I get SQL Server to give me an answer of 4. Now, the interesting thing here is if I go and plug in this same formula into a calculator, all right, we'll do 6 times 12 divided by 16, we get 4.5, which is not quite the 4 that SQL told us. So what's going on here? Does SQL Server not know how to perform basic mathematical calculations? Of course not. There are just some peculiarities of how SQL Server does handle these types of calculations, and that's what we're going to talk about in today's video. And this obviously has real-world repercussions if you've never had to deal with it before, because if I did actually listen to this answer of 4 that SQL Server is telling me, I would have built my walls with, you know, an overhanging piece of drywall because I didn't have enough lumber to finish the frame, and that would have been bad. And I'd like to just thank Kenneth Fisher for the idea for this video, because he's the one who prompted me asking, you know, what can I learn about SQL Server from a studio rebuild? And so jokingly, I tweeted back that simple math equation where the 0.5 is getting chopped off from the end. So the reason this happens is that anytime you perform any kind of calculations in SQL Server, SQL Server has to convert all the data types so that they match. And when SQL Server has to convert these data types, it chooses which data type to convert to based on data type precedence, picking the data type with the highest data type precedence. And while numeric data types have a higher data type precedence than their integer counterparts, because this original equation only deals with integers, SQL Server also outputs the value as an integer, which is why that 0.5 gets chopped off. So the quick and dirty way to fix this is to change the data types of one of our values in our equation to something like a numeric, to then have SQL Server do the calculation and output the value as numeric because it has to convert everything to numeric. So the easiest way to do that is just to add a 0.0 to the end of one of our numbers, and if we run it, you'll see we get the correct answer of 4.5. And you don't even need the full 0.0. As Andy Malin contributed to our conversation, adding just a period is enough to get SQL Server to convert to that numeric data type. Taking it even a step further, Pat Phelan suggested that you don't even need a decimal at all. You can just add the letter E, right, and 0, which will also give you a value of 4.5 as your output. So out of all these methods, adding the 0.0 is my favorite because it's the least ambiguous. However, there still is some ambiguity around it to someone who's never had to deal with these types of data type conversion problems, and they may decide that you don't really need that 0.0. So in addition to the 0.0, I actually like to explicitly cast my numbers or my full equations to get the exact output that I expect. If you're dealing with equations or calculations that are really important, like if you ever deal with money or having to calculate lumber or something like that in SQL Server where, you know, rounding errors make a big difference, adding an explicit cast is probably the best way to document via code, you know, what the intended output is. So why does this even matter, right? If you're working with or training someone who's maybe newer to SQL Server, the first time they encounter this type of issue where SQL Server is chopping off data, they may think that SQL Server is doing something completely wrong and unexpected. But now we know of these caveats with implicit conversions and data type precedents that cause SQL Server to behave the way it does. And these things have ramifications in the real world where we want our reports and our queries to give us accurate results. So that's it for this week's video. Thanks for hanging in there with me and for hanging along with this studio rebuild. I know it looks a little different. I promise it will be better next time, or at least I hope I'll have time to paint it all. But anyway, hope you enjoyed the video. Be sure to come back next week. If you're not a subscriber, subscribe so you won't miss any of these weekly videos, and I'll see you next time. Thanks.